Hey everyone, water is an absolute necessity for life, and people way smarter than me say you should be drinking at least 3 liters of water per day. So if you're going on a backpack hunt, carrying 3 liters of water per day is a ton of weight, and it makes a lot more sense just to source your water once you get to your campsite. So you're going to be camping near a water source and filtering that water every day for your drinking water and your cooking water. Alright, so right here we have a small running stream. It's a really good water source. Typically running water is going to be much better to drink than stagnant water. But even, you know, a clear running stream like this needs filtration or purification because there's a lot of harmful pathogens that you could ingest from that water. Things like cryptosporidium or giardia, both of which you definitely do not want to get. So what we're going to do is we're going to show you 4 different ways to make this water safe to drink. All right, so the first method for making water safe to drink is a water filter like this one. And what these do is you have one end that's gonna go into your water source, and then you're gonna pump it, and it's gonna pass water through a filter, and clean water comes out. These are a great option, but they do have some limitations. First and foremost, they take up space, and they weigh a little bit more than some of the other types of water purification systems we're gonna show you. And one thing is these filters can get clogged and they can also freeze. So just keep that in mind. Don't stick the end that goes into the water source into a mud puddle or something where a lot of debris can get clogged in your filter. And if it's gonna be below freezing, don't leave your filter out, you know, out in the cold. Bring it in, bring it close to your sleeping bag, something like that. But they're a really good option. One other thing I want to point out is that if you are planning to use it for travel or something like that, these won't filter out a virus. So most of these filters are around 150 microns and viruses are going to go right through that. So again, not something you have to worry about if you're just going to be using it inside the US, but if you're planning to use it for travel abroad, maybe one of the other options is much better. Number two is some type of chemical treatment like these water purification tablets. These are really easy to use. Read the directions on here, put the right number of tablets in per the amount of water that you're purifying, wait the prescribed amount of time in the directions, and then you have water that's safe to drink. They're really small, they don't take up a lot of space, they're really lightweight. The only downside is that when you do drink the water, you're gonna taste whatever chemical was used to purify it. So like, it's gonna have either like a chlorine or an iodine type flavor to it. So just keep that in mind. But these are a really great option if you wanna keep it in a survival kit or as a backup to some of the other options. One of my favorites is to use UV light to make this water safe to drink. It's really easy to use. On here, it has different settings for the amount of water that you're purifying. So you press the button, stick it in, it lights up, and then you stir it, and it has a timer that counts down. It's 90 seconds, and then your water is good to go. Now, the downside to this is that whatever is floating in here, because you're filling it up by, you know, dunking your water container in the water, there's no filter. So if there's something floating in the water or you kick up some silt, it's gonna end up in your water container, and then you're gonna drink that. So what you can do is you can take your t-shirt or a bandana, put it around the opening of your water container to use as kind of like a filter to get those big particulates out. It's not gonna hurt you, but it does make the water a little unappetizing. Anytime you're using any type of purification system, what you wanna keep in mind is cross-contamination. So for example, let's say I'm gonna use the UV light to filter out the water in this, and I've dunked this container in here, so all around this lid has contaminants on it. So if I were to put my mouth here, it would kind of defeat the purpose of purifying the water on the inside. That's where this comes into play. I put this cap on, and then I have my clean cap right here to drink out of. Keep things like that in mind. So if you're using a water filter, and you have one container that you're using to collect the water, another one you're using to drink out of, keep those separate, mark them so you're not swapping them back and forth. Now the final method for for making your water safe to drink would be boiling it. So if you're at sea level, just bring it to a rolling boil, 200 and something degrees, and everything in there that could hurt you, it's gonna be dead. At like 10,000 feet elevation, it's like a 180-ish boiling temperature. So boil it for like 5 minutes and you'll be good. Higher than that, I don't know, I've never been higher than that, so ask someone else. just kidding. There's charts out there where you can find that information. All right, so now you know how to make water safe to drink, whether it's for a backpack hunt or just for a survival situation. It pays to be prepared with either some water purification tablets or a water filter when you're going out on a long hike or a backpack hunt. I'm Scott with Bowhunting360. We'll see you in the next video.